Hey folks, Dave the not-so-evil EvilViking13 here, and I am back in Fallout 4 after the release of the Fallout 4 Creation Kit and the introduction of official Bethesda mods for Fallout. Now, what this has mainly meant for me is that a lot of my Nexus mods have been pretty much broken this week, so I've enjoyed a bit of a break from my usual Fallout 4 modding madness, and I'm definitely glad that I went ahead and finished my Spectacle Island builds as well as my Wasteland Workshop Arena because a lot of those mods did break, and I've been watching the updates trickle in, and I've just about got things running smoothly once again. We're back today to work on the Minutemen's Castle, which is basically the polar opposite of my Spectacle Island build. Now, before we dive in for some classic Minutemen, General Dave style building here at the castle, let me just briefly run over what you guys have possibly missed out on over the last few weeks. I do have an updated mod list, which includes the mods I've updated to be compatible with the recent Fallout 4 patches and DLCs. Everything that you guys need to match my mod list should now be in there. And in the very near future, I should be uploading a pack of my custom textures, at least so far. Additionally, as I mentioned, my largest build so far, Spectacle Island, which I rebuilt into Joel's Pleasure Island, did go live in April. And it's a two-part tour, absolutely massive. And then I also have a multi-part series based on the Wasteland Workshop DLC. And you guys can find links to that in the description. But for today, let's get back to building on the castle. And we're gonna take a bit of a left turn, and we're gonna start things off today by doing a bit of custom texturing. Just in case this episode ends up being a bit short due to continuing crashes in Fallout 4 since the recent updates, I wanted to do a bit of work outside of Fallout itself, and you guys have been asking here and there about my texture creating process. So, the first thing I'm going to do, you guys can see I'm in my Fallout 4 data directory, and this is the, I believe, the Better Businesses texture folder. You can see this is the custom sign that I made for Joel's Pleasure Island. Resolution is going to be 2048 by 1024. And it is DDS texture format. You can get a free plugin kit from the NVIDIA website that will let you open DDS texture files in Photoshop. But I actually work with them pretty often, so I already had all that good stuff installed. Wasn't too much of an issue at all. And there's the transparency channel right there that goes along the 3D mesh of the billboard and gives it some of those broken panel effects. The texture that I actually want to work on, though, it's going to be one of the sail banners right here. Okay. Boston Public Library, and then a large sail banner. I'm seeing no transparency for any of these, actually. Which one do I want to edit? Well, I'm pretty sure that I've seen this green one somewhere in-game before, and what I'm referring to, guys, is this texture sheet, because it is a square format and has to be square, it's got a couple of different signs on this texture sheet. So each one of these is probably going to be a separate texture. So I'm just going to basically chop off this section right here. That was a terrible selection. There we go. And I'm going to copy and paste that into a new layer. Now, this being the Minutemen's capital, I want a bit of General Dave propaganda. I've been playing a bit of Fallout here and there, and I do believe that I have a screenshot of my in-game character here somewhere. Yeah, here we go. Not an amazing screenshot, but I updated my tactical beard to better match my real life one. So what I'm thinking for this fabric banner, let's take a look at our mask. I'm thinking some kind of large version of my face, just with General Dave on top, just with some fabric effects. Nothing too fancy, but basically just some Orwellian propaganda for the castle. I'm going to just unlink the mask so I can drag the image back and forth, figure out the best way to align it. That looks pretty good. I'm going to add a saturation adjustment. Don't want to make it black and white, but I want to fade out those colors. And then I also want to... Let's up the contrast. It's going to make my eyes kind of disappear, but I think that works okay. I'll up the brightness just a bit. I'm watching how it looks in the navigator window up here. Okay. That's a decent starting point. Next up, from, I believe, just textures.com. Yeah, textures.com. I've got my texture library, and I have just a fabric texture right here. I'm going to slap that on top. This one is a nice light color, which will make it great for overlays. Now let's go ahead and see what options we have. Change it to darken, change it to multiply. Multiply works okay. Screen. Yeah, too washed out. Color dodge. Way too bright. Soft light actually works pretty well. On the other hand, though, I really like the effect that hard light gives the texture. Makes it look like it was very roughly printed. And just to add to the effect, I'm going to add a blur to the image so it's not too sharp and digital. Okay. This being a vertical banner, I'm thinking of doing some text that just says General. Now, it looks like I've got Purista selected as my text. The typeface that I usually use, both for my YouTube channel and for stuff in Fallout, is one of my favorite old-style typefaces, Futura. And I'm going to do maybe condensed bold, maybe medium. Ah, medium regular. That looks great. Perfect. Don't worry, we're going to add some effects to it to help it blend in. I'm going to make it 110. And I'll put the spacing between lines at 110 as well. And if we go down, let's make it all capitals. Let's make that spacing 80. Well, that's too close. 90. Okay. That's pretty good. Let's make sure we're left aligned. That might look a little funky, but let's give it a shot. I'll say 100 for the spacing. Well, this is the idea that I had for the text, but honestly, guys, I don't know if that's going to look nice. The E's here are just too squashed, and they don't line up with really anything. So rather than trying to size things manually, what I will do is go back to center alignment for the... I guess it's technically a paragraph according to Photoshop. This is the most ridiculous piece of propaganda. This is pretty great. Okay, general, and then I'll just add the Dave over here. Doing shift enter to drop down to new lines, and Vertical text is generally something you don't want to do too much of, but I think we can get away with it in this case. Let's see. I just don't like how it's lining up with the text, the background image, that is. And this makes my background screenshot look like a creeper. But that does leave more room for the text, and it's still pretty clear that it's me with the beard and the trident hat. So yeah, guys, actually, I kind of like how that looks. Now, to give this that apocalyptic printed cloth look, I'm going to make a copy of these text layers. I'm going to rasterize them, Control E to make them one layer, and then I'm going to blur them just a tiny bit. Let's say 1.5 pixels. Okay. And I'm going to take my smudge tool and let's give it just a couple of printing mistakes, like the N is a little bit off, and the R, the V. We just want to get rid of just a couple of these perfectly shaped digital lines where it's like it was printed by hand, carefully, but still by hand. And finally, I'm going to do a warp transform just to give the overall text itself just some random shape. Not too much. Don't make it wavy. It's not a flag. It's just a real rough print. I'm going to set the opacity for this layer down to 90%. Well, let's do 83%. And then, is it already below our fabric? Oh, it is. Okay. In that case, I am going to make a duplicate of our fabric, mask it for just the text, and if we multiply it, that'll give a little bit of texture to the text itself. And because that's a direct copy of the other fabric layer, everything should line up. And there we have it, guys. That's a pretty complete fabric style banner. I'm going to try to blur it just a little bit more on the background image. Turn that off and on. Yeah, that looks way too much like a screenshot with no blur. And with the blur, that looks pretty good. So these will be hanging banners that I will just place all around the castle. And there will be more signs coming. I just thought you guys might enjoy a sneak peek at what I have planned. If Spectacle Island was an island of horrors, the Minutemen's headquarters will be a much nicer place, just with a lot of that Orwellian, overlording General Dave propaganda. So, I think all we're missing here, guys, is just a little bit of wear and tear. Let's add some weathering, and I've got a couple of grunge brushes here. Not as big as my collection used to be, but they should do the trick. Got gray for my color. Let's take a look at that. That's pretty good. Way too strong. I do like that brush, though. I guess there would be a higher likelihood of water stains down at the bottom. So I'll add that one there. That one's so light you almost can't see it. Okay, let's go for some stronger grunge. Maybe, here we go. Good grief, that is a massive brush. I'll go ahead and just do a new layer there. Let's darken our color too. Well, that looks like tar. Okay. Let's lower that opacity way down. I think a second brush along the bottom to complement that would look good. There we go. This one's kind of an L shape. That could be good for the upper right-hand corner. It's a little strong. Let's increase the size and put it right on the edge. Yeah. Want to make sure that I get some splotches on the white text to help blend that. Put a slight band off there, off to the side. This one's just kind of grungy, dingy pieces. That could work well right there. Still want kind of a vertical shape though. How about this one? I'm gonna pull the opacity way down for that one. There we go. That looks good. What do we have here? I'm not really seeing any more really good vertical options. Let's see. Print stains. Oh, here we go. Kind of like a splatter. Don't want to overdo it, but I still want to cover a little more on the left side here. So this could count as both weather stains and printing accidents. Okay, again, don't want to overdo it. That looks good though. Let's put all of these into a folder. Call it wear. And then let's make sure that we give it a mask to just add it on top of our custom flag here. There we go. There's the plain, no wear and tear version, and the weathered version. That'll help it blend in. Again, because we don't have any actual transparency alpha channels in this texture. Save it as a DDS texture. Overwrite the old one. Make sure that we don't have the option that has the alpha channel selected. It's usually DXT5. Don't need it in this case. There is no alpha channel. Just do a DXT1, no alpha. And save it. And there we go, guys. Our texture should now be able to be seen in game. So let's go back to the castle and check it out. And we're back at the castle. I'm looking around here and trying to figure out the best place to try out the new flag. Blocking the stairs. I don't think I'm gonna put one on the front of the entrance because that'd be kind of distracting for visitors, right? Let's see what we have though. There's the first banner, there's the second one. These are definitely going up in my office from the, what is it, the Museum of Freedom, I think. And here it is, General Dave. Wow, that is seriously just Orwellian. Now, that's actually a little bit too big, so I'm just going to do a set scale, do 0.75, and then disable it, and enable it. And now we have our smaller banner. I chose 0.75 so that it'll be pretty easy to remember if I want to resize others. I might be able to actually get that balanced on each side. Let's see. So off the end of the windows, if I do one of them, it'd be about, let's see, so right there at that line, right there. I might just hang it down so it matches. So disable and enable. It can just hang down below the deck, that's fine. And seeing it's having a hard time actually grabbing that again, I'll just use the auto hotkey script to nudge it into place. You guys can actually see a lot of that wear and tear that we added on the texture. That looks pretty cool. Just needs to go a little bit further back. And I think I can just scoot the deck out to make room for it too. There we go. General Dave. And that's actually balanced for each side. I'm also gonna get rid of this lantern right here. I think that came with the OC decorator mod. I'm gonna add the official Bethesda one, and hopefully that one won't get knocked over. And then I'll show you guys what we're gonna work on today. There's the candles. I really like that lantern though. If I can just figure out where it is. Oil lamp. I think this is the Bethesda one. Yeah, it has that nice animated flame inside. Very cool. Okay. Well, weather's not really going to matter as far as the fog and the daytime goes, because today we're going to work on my quarters and my office, which is, I think, this room. Let's take one more look around. Okay, no, it's this room. I was gonna say, I felt like wouldn't make much sense to have my quarters near the prisoner area, the holding cells. Okay. Do I want the conference room to be somewhere else, or?
Identity confirmed.
Got room for the medic here. Detective Valentine's office, our bar. So we have two large quarter rooms to choose from. And the question is going to be, again, do I separate my office out or try to make them all in one? We have that giant pile of debris in the corner of that room. Let's look back here again. I think this was supposed to be additional living space, but we do have 35 beds already, thanks to all of our extra barracks, so we really don't need additional beds. We haven't even added the beds in the holding cells yet. So I could definitely make this its own conference room. Can I not pick that up? I bet I can move it with the auto hotkey script. Yes, I can. So even though the place anywhere mod did not move it, the script can. I want to keep this unique rug either way, because I can't actually build anything like this, so I don't want to delete it or scrap it. Okay. Well, that's not aligned with the door at all. Thinking about the entrance to the underground in the other room, it's got a lot of debris piled up. If I made this the conference room, I wouldn't have to deal with that. I think it would be easier to deal with that pile of debris if that room was just my bedroom. I do like the setup they have here with the table and the rug on top. I can actually just move that. Cool. Alright, there are way too many robots at the castle right now. I actually beat the Automatron DLC a few weeks back. Just haven't gone through and moved some of the robots. The castle was just nice and close. So yeah, guys. I'm going to make this the conference room, and I will make the previous room my personal quarters. I think I'm going to empty out my personal quarters first, and we'll start with that area as far as working on it goes. Just gonna store those chairs in the workshop. I'll keep that rug for now. But I feel like I'm going to actually add a wood floor in here. So, yeah, you know what? We got a high ceiling to work with. I want to cover up this floor. I'll just scrap that rug and move this lamp. I do like that lighting effect. Okay. And I am going to quick save pretty often because I was getting some crashes to desktop trying to use a achievement enabler mod for Fallout 4 script extender along with the place everywhere mod, and those two mods appeared to conflict. I was getting all kinds of crashes. It looks like it's fixed, but I'm a bit paranoid now, so I am gonna just quick save a lot. That is far too crappy of a bed for the general. Is there a rocket in that cabinet? I'll just store that, store you, store you. Definitely want to keep those cigars. That's pretty awesome. Move that painting up. So yeah, guys, let's see what I can do with this floor. Again, paranoid saving. Let's check out Snap and Build, Real Estate. This should have some nicer floors. That's an old wood floor. I'm looking for a kind of new looking wood floor. It's not going to be, you know, absolutely modern, but those cost four. These cost four too, so let's try them out. Looks like a ship deck. That's far too new looking. That's also a bit log cabin like. That is most definitely concrete. Well, guys, I'm not really seeing a whole lot that I like here. This, though, this I can work with. This very old style wood floor. And if I put that like that and center it, again using the Place Anywhere mod to get it clipped in. Raise it up just a bit. Okay. No, don't store it. What kind of options for stairs am I going to have? Do we have any little tiny pieces for stairs? We got these. I'll turn off collision and just let it snap like that. turn snapping for objects back on. So that works pretty well. But it clips into the door. So I'm going to move this floor back and create an entranceway. If I can get it lined up correctly. There we go. And again, a lot of you guys ask why I don't use mods like spring cleaning and whatnot to clean up some of the pre-placed objects. And I do like working with what is actually here. I don't mind trying to find ways around things like piles of debris by doing things like raising the floor. And those mods have had some issues with the, you know, save corrupting and stuff like that in the past. And I'm trying to trim down my mods that I'm using just a bit, especially now that official mod support is out. And it's very easy to get carried away with how many mods you're installing, so trying to focus again on the important ones. That looks good, good, good. Still some debris here, but that I can work with. Okay. Gonna move all of these up together. Oop. Come on, ashtray. Why can I not click on that ashtray? You know what? I'm gonna scrap it and place one with OC decorator later. That looks good there. Let's lower the case back down. 1, 2. 1, 2. Oop. 1, 2. And 1, 2. Okay. Paranoid quick saving. Now that's looking pretty classy, guys. Pretty classy indeed. We should have some small tiles here that I can place. That's marble. There we go. I just don't want these pieces sticking, whoop, all the way through the wall. Okay. Nothing poking through on this side. Let's rotate that to match. I'll just clip this in like that. Okay, looking good there. Got a slight hole there, but perhaps I can fill it with some furniture. Very fancy. I'm not liking these industrial style lights. I'm going to go ahead and remove those for now. And in honor of our construction site, let's add some work lights so we can see what we're doing. These are always fun to use. Past all my spotlights here. Good grief, where are the work lights? There you are. Now we can see, and I love that those do add the shadows. Now I'm gonna put up all of these paintings because I am thinking about changing these cinder block walls into something totally different. Yeah, guys, check out these wall panels right here. We have larger versions. Yeah, we do. Okay. Let's turn off all snapping entirely. This could look really cool for both my bedroom and the boardroom. Try to get it lined up just right. Turn snapping back on. Will it snap? Nope, that's actually going to cause more problems than it's going to solve. Come on now, no seams. And I am going to toggle free cam just for a second to check on the outside. Okay, some of the floor pieces are clipping through, but that's not super distracting, and there's nothing else actually on this side of the castle that we're going to be worrying with. Please ignore the vertebrate above my quarters. Nothing to see there. I have done just a little bit of work outside of Spectacle Island over here, as you guys can see. Okay. Let's do that piece. And then... oh, nice. I can actually fit that and line it up like that with the stone that's around the doorway. Now this is going to be tricky because I've got to move everything out. Bit by bit. Is that enough space? We'll see here in a second. Start back here in the corner. One thing about working with placement is you really can't trust your perspective, especially here in first person. When you're working in 3D, you want to kind of check the cross section as much as possible. I don't have the option to check the cross section, so I kind of just have to take my best guess and then do slight adjustments later. And we're back, guys, and unfortunately the game did crash. I lost a little bit of work, but I think I've narrowed it down to being caused by me toggling snapping on and off. Toggling off, snapping, as well as surface collision. So, I can still use the Place Everywhere mod for now, as long as I just leave all the snapping options turned on. And I'll see if I can dig into that more after I record this and see if I can figure out what's going on. I've been toying with it on and off for the last few days, which is why Fallout has been a bit quiet recently. But I think I have it working for now. Okay, this is the kitchen. Piper, just chill.
Wait there.
Okay, I'll be here then.
Okay. What I have done, though, is while seeing if I can avoid the crashes, I went ahead and finished the rest of the woodworking here in my personal quarters. And that looks basically exactly as I had imagined it. That's awesome. Just what I wanted. I'm going to jog down the hallway here. Show you guys what the conference room looks like. I went with a marble floor and just a few bits of stone and wood detailing. Now, I wanted this room to primarily be the stonework because I liked the ivy and the old posters over here. I like that clock already being there. And I have a plan for these stone walls. fix some of those blur glitches real quick. Okay. I think this is the absolute perfect room for those gigantic flags from the museum. Put one there. Ooh, they actually wave. In that case, I'm gonna scoot it out from the wall. That is awesome! We'll add one here as well. That needs to also come off the wall just a bit. They're waving like crazy. Okay. Still, though, I think we can work with that. I like the idea a lot. And I'll do the American flag here. And put the Minutemen flag below that. No giant General Dave signs for in here. Let's scoot you out from the wall just a bit. Not you. There we go. And yes, I am working on Sarge 2.0. He's in pre-alpha, as you can see.
We can keep traveling as much as you want. I don't require sleep or food in order to survive.
It's a little bit more wind than I wanted, but as long as I can keep them off the wall enough where they won't clip through, I think that'll work just fine. There we go. Yeah. As it clips through immediately. I'm just trying to compare how each one is laid out. If I bring them off the wall a lot, just make them big curtains, maybe it'll calm down some. Although this one needs to go a little bit to the right, it looks like. That footlocker over here. Move these two filing cabinets over here. I guess those will probably be the only two that I hang in here because they're taking up so much space. Have our conference table for the Minutemen commanders. There we go. Let's see. I'm thinking some kind of snack table would make sense. Maybe a wet bar for drinks. Let's put this over here. A few of these wall pieces are kind of stuck too. There we go. That light's a little bit harsh. But now it's pitch black. Okay. Well. I'll place a few more pieces of furniture in here. And this could be my working desk out here. Yeah. Plenty of waving flags to distract me. I'll add that to the communication center. I like that. Got a dresser, but I think we're actually looking pretty good on furniture in here. As far as just storage goes. I'll add perhaps one more filing cabinet. Trying to think where I'm going to leave room for that wet bar. No, not enough room for the third filing cabinet. I might put a weapons locker just outside, though, in case of attack. Put a slightly cleaner fridge in here. For serving drinks from. And I'll put a wall safe back here. Steamer trunk. Now a trash can, that makes sense. Put one next to my desk too. We do have the army trunk. I'll put that in this corner. Will that block possible lamps? That might block lamps, so. Gonna actually see if I can fit this somewhere else. I do like the idea of the trunk. Sorry guys, I know it's kind of dark right now. Let me fix that next. Okay. I might actually use some of the more modern lights. Modern style, at least. Looking for those small ones. Oh yeah, we have some new Wasteland Workshop lights too. How would this track light look if it was somewhere like right here? Not great. Oh, here we go. The smaller one casts a better light, I think. More like a spotlight. That's really cool. Okay. I do like that. I'm thinking some of these small lights for the table. A small light for my desk. Might need to run more power back there. I'll do an orange light here and an orange light here. But we are going to have to power those up. Is that centered? That is centered. Okay. Where does that power go to? To right there. So I can actually do a quick save first. Because I'm going to have to glitch the power line through the wall. And it may not like that. Power conduit. Oop. Pull it out here. Link the wire, and then just move the cable itself. And now we have light. Neat. I really like the light in the marble. That is a neat effect. Okay. What's next? I mentioned, after we save, I mentioned that I wanted to do some kind of sink or bar or something in here, so let's look at that next. I got the countertops. But I think there's just some small counters too. Yeah. I think I'm liking the wood everything better than having an actual sink in here. Shop counter. Shop counter. Small tables. Yeah, I might just use one of the big bar pieces. This one's gonna be too big. Far too big. One of these might do the trick. Yeah, there we go. Got a little bit crowded though. There we go. I think that works better. There's just really no room for that steamer trunk in here anymore. I'll toss it aside for now. Put that door back on. I guess without the steamer trunk there, we have a little more room to put that over to the right, just a bit more, and I just put that inside of a wall. Where did it go? Is it in the wall? Oh boy. Okay, my camera's in the wall. Okay, no, it's just behind the wall. Let me get it back out of there. And turn the free cam back off. There's just no point in wasting build size on objects that are stuck in the wall, you know? That is worth digging back out. I think we need a lamp in that corner, too. Move this trash can to over here. That lamp centered? I don't think it is. There we go. So, for further decorations, we need our conference room chairs. And what else? Need my chair. But first let's add those extra lamps because it is still a little bit dark in here. And, oh no, I'm going to have to scroll past all of them again. Okay, I'll do one like this. If I can just get it in that corner there. Close enough. Move the trash cans over there. One more lamp for this corner. It's really bothering me that these lamps aren't lined up. There we go. Just making mental notes here, looking around. I think before we place the chairs, I'm going to place a couple of the Minutemen flags on each side of the door. But just to make you guys suffer through it one more time, I did forget to put one final small lamp like these over here on this piece of furniture to the left of the door. Like so. That is a dim little light. But it does make for a dramatic conference room, that's for sure. I think... Are the standalone flags under the flag category? They might not be. I think they might be... Yeah, they're under a different category. I don't think the bunting's really gonna fit in anywhere down here. But I might want to remember it for other sections of the castle. Someone just fell. I believe the flags I'm looking for, though, are going to be under structures and miscellaneous. It's where a lot of the waving flags are, so yeah, there's the anarchy flag. Brotherhood of Steel, Institute, Minutemen. I do love that high-res Minutemen flag texture. Is that lined up? That is a dramatic entrance, guys. So what that leaves is a security guard getting stuck on the flag. I'm not gonna bother with a guard post in front of the door. There's one here next to the cells. That's close enough. What I was gonna say was, what that leaves is some kind of rug underneath my desk, and I do have a mod that adds a few more of those. We'll go with a very fancy red rug. Let's lower that one down a bit too. Put that right there. Move my desk back. Keeping everything lined up. Everything centered. as best we can. Okay. That leaves our chairs for in here. Well, let's see what kind of options I have here. Do a very fancy chair. Yeah, let's actually use this one for once. Something a little bit different. Now for the conference table, I'm thinking, do we want to go with classic chairs or these wooden chairs? These chairs were here before, and I kind of like their simple style with the roll wheels and all, so I'm just gonna place a bunch of these. Scoot a few of them in there. And while we're over here, I'm going to go to wall decorations. And we're going to put George Washington on the wall over here. There he is. And I think maybe one more painting like that for the other wall. Do we have any smaller ones? There we go. A nice small landscape for above the filing cabinets. Getting very close here, guys. This is looking really awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and put a terminal down for my desk. And a radio as well. Could we add a wall radio for Radio Freedom? Yeah, we could. Put it right there under the clock. I think I still have Radio Freedom completely turned off, though. I know I can just mute the speaker, but just haven't gone back yet. Miscellaneous. So I'm trying to remember, there might be one that is just decorative. Ceiling lights. Interactive number two. It's a double category. Might just be under miscellaneous. And there won't be things like the map console or anything like that in here. They'll be outside in the communications bunker that we placed quite a long time ago, actually. Now, a monitor bank. I hadn't thought about that. Museum operations terminal. If that would just collide, we'd be set. Yeah, I'll just place an actual terminal. just trying to decide if I do want one of those monitor banks in here. I guess in theory I could have access to some feeds off of the terminal or something like that. I don't know. I'm trying to justify not having a giant glowing bank of monitors in here. And I have put decontamination arches at all the castle entrances, by the way. Yeah, you know what, guys? I don't think the monitors would fit in well in here. This is a very fancy, very nice conference room. I've got officers in the communications bunker to monitor feeds, so no giant glowing screens for that. Instead, I will place under decorations and miscellaneous a non-working terminal? Huh, interesting. I'm looking for the nice plants and that sort of thing. But we do also have armor stands. As always, guys, I am very easily distracted. Could we not, robots? See, Adam Katz, that the Minutemen General? Yeah, it's the General. This is just General Minutemen. So I'm going to put him in the corner. Nice. If we keep going past my distractions, though, I will get distracted again by an ashtray. But we will keep chugging on towards all the plants and planters. Hot coffee set. I need to get some more loot so I can build those again. Diploma. Suffolk County School of Law. Why are you guys all swarming into my conference room? Go away. Got medication, drinks, oil lamp, poles and hooks. There we go. Potted plant. Is there a smaller one for the table? Yes. Do a fern up there. A large potted plant here. Perhaps a large one . Well, there's really nowhere else for a large one. I'm gonna store that footlocker and put it over here. Put a single fern over on this side. That one's going to be way too big. Yeah, all those are pretty huge. Wall bell. Now that I can get behind. Ooh. Candles on the walls. Would that look better than the larger lamps? That might be too much, guys. Ah, man. I want to use these, but Yeah, that's too much for this room. Should've just moved the light aside. I forgot that those were even in here, though. I might have to use those in my personal quarters. Well, that's enough plants, I believe. We're running out of floor space, actually. That texture is flickering. On the armor stand, there we go.
I wish more people could see this. Remind them what it's all about.
Yeah, let's put that light back. And of course, they're sorted all the way to the end once again. Yeah, I do like those modern lights, even with our old stylings in here. And guys, as far as decorations go, I'm not really going to place a whole lot of small ones in this room. This is going to be a very well-kept, clean conference room. I think all I'm going to put in here at all are some cups and things like that on the countertop, which is a bit bare. But I'm going to leave my desk and the conference table mostly clear of anything. Let's go to clutter. And then kitchen. Got dispensers. That's a very obnoxious espresso machine. Put a few hot plates down. A few coffee pots. I thought I had more untarnished ones, but I guess not. Oh, I'm actually out of coffee pots completely. No toasters in the conference room. I will put a little bit of bourbon in the cabinet. And some bourbon on the table. Some wine. Got vodka. Whiskey on my desk. That's the only thing going on my desk. Maybe a cup to go with it. I think Croup Manor, which is of course my Croup Manor hotel, will do just fine against that attack. Pre-war coffee cups. I think I stole these from the Institute. Just put three down. Shot glasses. And a shot glass for my whiskey. Tarnished coffee tin. No lunch boxes, but I will put a couple of clean white plates down here. I can get them to actually connect. There we go. Yeah, guys, I'm not going to overdo it with the decorations for this room because there's still so much more to come. So that's where I'm going to stop. There is our conference room for General Dave. I think I'm trying to make up for the griminess that was Pleasure Island with this build. And with that, we are out of time for today. But in the next episode, I'm going to be returning to my personal general's quarters, and we'll be decorating and detailing that. From there, I think it's probably going to be the bar and the kitchen next, and then I'll be taking a look at that main grand entrance. As always, guys, thank you for watching. Also, don't forget to check out the other videos going live on the channel this week. We've got a little bit of Arma, a little bit of Witcher, and definitely some more Witcher to come as I am ramping back up my Witcher enjoyment to get ready for the Blood and Wine DLC. That's it for now though. I'll see you guys next time.